Hello friends, this is the solution video for question number 21, chapter 6, HC Verma. The problem statement says, the friction coefficient between the board and the floor shown in figure is mu. Find the maximum force that man can exert on the rope so that the board does not slip on the floor.
So in this problem, say this man is standing on this block and try to visualize that. So if this man will pull this rope in the downward direction, so that means this block will try to move in the right hand direction. Okay, but we have to find the maximum force that this man can apply on this rope so that this block will not move in the right hand direction. Okay, so let's say this man is applying a tension T in this rope. Since this rope is same, so tension is T everywhere. Okay, there will be a frictional force which will act in the opposite direction. Now I'm considering this man and the block as a one system. So let's say this is the one system which have mass m plus m. Downward force will be m plus m into g due to gravity. The reaction force is in upward direction. The tension T is in the right hand direction and the frictional force is in backward direction. There is an additional force in the upward direction, that is T, which is applied by the man on the string. Okay, so this is the T which is acting in the upward direction. Okay, now since this block is not moving, so that means the acceleration of this block is zero. So now writing the equation of motion in the horizontal direction, so I can say T minus F is equal to mass into acceleration, and acceleration is zero, so that means it is zero. So this implies T is equal to F. Now putting the value of frictional force, which is T is equal to mu into R. Let's say this is equation 1. Now for the vertical equilibrium, so there are two forces acting on the upward direction, so R plus T must be equal to M plus M into G. Now from here we will get the value of R as M plus M into G minus T. Let's say this is equation 2. Now putting the value of R from equation 2 into 1, so we will get T is equal to mu times the value of R is M plus M into G minus T. Now further solving this, T is equal to mu M G plus mu M G minus mu into T. I'll take this mu T into the left hand direction, so this will become T common. 1 plus mu is equal to, now I'm taking mu g common, mu into g, m plus m. Now the value of T is mu g m plus m upon 1 plus mu. So this is a maximum force which a man can apply on this situation so that the block will not move. Okay, so this is the solution of this problem.